Good morning, I'm Juan Perez, Senior Foreign Exchange Trader and Strategist here at Tempest. Thank you so much, of course, for joining us on our weekly review of what's happening to the dollar and where it might head. We are, of course, at the start of a very exciting week because it is the beginning of the World Cup. We cannot hide that excitement here in this office, of course. Naturally, there are a lot of things that that are also very worldly going on, and international relations and free commerce as we know it is starting to change, and dramatically so. The G7 summit did happen over the weekend, and of course, President Trump did follow with his agenda of coming into the meeting, but not in, staying the entire summit, as he is readying himself in Singapore to actually meet with North Korean officials. Kim Jong Un is expected to also be seeing the president. So, of course, a very historic situation. But the foreign exchange market is not really reacting much to that, as much as it is reacting to international trade being threatened. And President Trump has been very adamant in what his policies will be, in also negotiating deals his way. The equity market and the stock markets across the world are the ones that have significantly seen the impact. The commodity markets are also in a tremendous downturn because of the uncertainty over what may happen to the established centralized international system of trade that has actually been mostly controlled by the United States and the United Kingdom, which are countries that, of course, are going through some major political changes. And in that happening, it causes the domino effect of, you know, what's going to happen to our nation's role in international trade. Every single country is asking itself this question. Naturally, the dollar started losing a little bit of ground after being really, in comparison to where it's been in the past few years, it's been at an incredible level of performance, the best since 2015, at a 7-week consecutive level of growth. However, the advancement has been put to a halt because there are certain uncertainties that are starting to weigh on the dollar a little bit, and the political turmoil in Italy has dissipated slightly, especially now that the government has been advanced. In fact, over the weekend, the Italian finance minister, which was feared would actually be very negative in terms of his, you know, talking about the euro, no, has said there are no economic plans that would make the Italian economy separate itself from the European Union in any way. So that, of course, is a sign of relief. The European Central Bank is going to be talking this week, and we'll see if that's going to weigh on the euro at all, because it's recovered 1.2% of its value ever since the beginning of last week. So the euro is on a heavy run, finally, because its political instability issues are starting to go away, while perhaps the European Central Bank on Thursday is going to be feel confident enough to talk, hey, in September we are ready to get away from the financial intervention of quantitative easing, which is the sovereign bond purchasing program they've been having for quite a while, for the past 40 years or so. We also got to talk about the pound, because it's sinking once again. It's down to its worst levels in 6-7 months, and the reason why it's swimming there is because the economy is truly showing the signs of the Brexit uncertainty, with not only GDP in the first quarter coming in at just 0.1%, but manufacturing contracting by 0.8% in April, the beginning of the second quarter, which demonstrates that perhaps the second quarter could have some recessionary pressures. And this is actually the worst manufacturing gauge that the UK has seen in 5.5 years. So there are issues with trade, there are geopolitical concerns. The dollar stays afloat, not against the euro, because the political crisis has come to somewhat of an end. We'll see with central bank action. Of course, the Fed is expected to hike rates on Wednesday. If they follow through, that may help the dollar gain levels that it had seen last week. But if there is any hesitation, we'll see if there is a recovery all across the board against the US dollar. Thank you so much. Of course, leave any comments or questions, and we'll have a very heavy week to digest once we see you guys again at the beginning of the next week. Thank you.